Hello, everybody. It's Django Fett, the Angry Vet, here with another episode. I know I haven't been posting in a while. Just been busy with school, family, and a whole bunch of other shit. You know, life, let's call it, that has unfortunately decreased my time with my hobby. However, sorry for the damn air conditioning. I'll turn it down a little bit. However, it's been a good week so far. A lot of things going on, good things. I'm doing good in school, thank God. Pretty much the lowest grade I've gotten in a class has been a B, so I'm kind of happy about that, kind of stoked. Given it's online and you got a lot more freedom, but considering that I wanted to enjoy my daughter and enjoy, pretty much enjoy life. All right, it's been army for the past 10 and a half years almost. And this is the first time I got to enjoy my family. When I left the army, there's certain things that I could have done, but you know, it is what it is. A new chapter. I turned to roll with the punches, and this is where I am right now. I'm doing my degree on. Just finished working out, doing a nice pump on my shoulders, chest, and triceps. Yeah, a little unactive. I'm doing Hugh Jackman's little work routine with a little tweak on my own because I have a bad back and fucked up knee, so. I know I won't be squatting with a bar on the back. I'll probably be doing with dumbbells, kind of like farmer type thing. And I mean, it's more practical for me at least, and less painful on my back in that regard. Just happy to be here, man. Today's subject is bullying. What do I think about bullying? Especially considering how kids are nowadays. First of all, I don't know what the fuck is going on with parents. I had the experience at a wedding, and you know, the kids were on the playground, and the eldest kids almost ran over the little ones, you know, and that kind of pissed me the fuck off, because my daughter was one of them. I wanted to choke slam the head out of some kids, actually the parents, because that's taught at home. Once I took charge of the situation, like a good old drill sergeant, and a good old army sergeant, because I was never a drill sergeant, fuck that. They kind of stabilize a little bit, but, you know, waiting your turn and stuff like that should be taught at home. You know, learning to share should be taught at home, especially in a public place. Had an issue with a freaking parent leaving their kid outside while they were drinking and partying. Threw me the fuck out of the fucking... I was pissed. And given, I am not going to win Father of the Year. I am fucking not going to win that. Not gonna fucking win it, because there's a lot of shit that I gotta learn. I'm still learning. I suck at some stuff. I still suck at brushing the hair. I still suck at being a father, even though I am trying, considering the example I had growing up. That being said, I think I'm doing okay, but compared to other facts, like, it raised my self-esteem. How my daughter acted, given my daughter has a temper, and that's, she has Polish and Puerto Rican blood in her, that was coming. I'm fucked in that regard, and pardon my French. But, you know, you gotta teach your kids not to be assholes. That's taught at home, all right? Because if your kid's not taught not to be an asshole, some other kid's gonna teach him by beating the crap out of him. I, for example, will train my daughter to defend herself. Plain and simple, she's not gonna be a victim, because the only certain way that you stop a bully is by beating the living fucking shit out of him. Or her. All this peaceful crap absolutely might work. It works one time out of 100. Because half the time is that fucking kid hasn't gotten the ass whooping it deserves. Alright? Their parents let them do whatever the fuck they want. Don't put discipline on and talk back to the parents and stuff like that. I have to hold back my daughter talking to me back. It still aggravates the crap out of me. And right now she can get away with it a little bit because she's a child and she's learning. But I know her mother, when she gets old, is not going to put up with that. I sure shit ain't. I know her mother won't, but she's already not putting up with it. You got to put the boundaries on kids. You got to teach them boundaries, respect, sharing. Because being sociable is part of society. And if you don't teach your kid how to interact with other people, they're going to be either shitbags, pariahs, or they're going to end up killing themselves when they're 15. Sad but truth. You got to teach them, you know. And you got to teach them that adversity is part of life. You cannot fix everything. Like, for example, my daughter, simple stuff. My daughter, for example, and I know I'm getting away a little bit away from bullying, but she was doing like a puzzle and a little tablet thing, puzzle. I like her to do puzzles and stuff like that. And she will get mad and go, Nimoga, Nimoga, which means I can't. I can't. Meaning she felt that she couldn't do it. Like, no, sweetie, it's not that you can't do it. You just don't know how to do it yet. I'm going to teach you how to do it, and then you're going to do it yourself. And, you know, I let her do it. I mean, she'll mess up. She'll get frustrated. You got to be patient with your child. You know, sometimes I'm not patient with mine. I'm getting better at that. Anyway, you work with your child a little bit, and you let them fail a couple of times, and then you teach them. They show them the way. Don't do it for them. Just show them the way, and then have them do it. And when she finally figures it out by her own, her eyes light up. She's like, Daddy, Daddy, Daddy. And that's what you want to hear. Positive reinforcement has got such a good way. Sometimes you got to put the whip, but most of the time, you got to put the calming hand on the child. And it works a lot. And that's, I think it's why my daughter is learning English so fast. And now she's like diving into Spanish too, which is incredible. But it's because of the positive reinforcement. You know, like I said, once again, I am not going to win Father of the Year. I fucking suck at it. I'm trying my best I can, but I fucking suck at it. I mean, my daughter's happy, but most of the time it's her mother. It's not me. I'm just along for the ride sometimes. And I'm trying to do more and understand more. And you know, I gotta, you know, like I say, I'm still in the soldier mentality. It still hasn't left me. It freaking annoys the crap out of me. But I don't think it's not, I mean, 10 years doing the same thing. I feel bad for people that have been 20, 30 years of doing stuff and stuff like that. I mean, there's stuff that I fucking let go real quick, like the fucking organization and like constantly fucking cleaning to the chagrin of my significant other. She fucking hates it. I drive her insane. But there are other stuff that, like, especially like, okay, kid, you got to do what I tell you right now. Like, and he aggravates the crap out of me. Sometimes my daughter doesn't do it. But I got to understand she's a 2-year-old and stuff like that. The same thing with picking up. And I hate picking up over and over. I got to understand she's a 2-year-old and stuff like that. But at home, you teach your kid not to be a dick. Teach your kids, from time to time, spank them. They're not going to fucking die. They're not made of fucking paper. They will survive. And sometimes if the kid is strong, like, you got to put the freaking handle of it. But I think all kids can be educated. I did it with shitbag soldiers, and I was able to reform them and they were able to stay in and keep going forward. I think you can do it with a fucking young child, you know. I think you can do it with a young child. You just need to be tough on them, because some childs will, kids are constantly trying to find out what they can get away with. And if you let them get away with often, they're going to say, okay, well, that's the right thing to do. And they'll keep doing it. And good luck on educating that. I'm telling you one thing. Don't teach your kid. Like, if your kid's a fucking bully, fix him, or somebody else will fix him. I'm sorry, but when I see a bully getting his ass beat, I feel no fucking remorse whatsoever. Like, that fucking guy that was picking up on a blind kid, and the other kid laid him the fuck out. If that would have been my kid, I would have fought that suspension, because he's a fucking piece of shit. How the fuck are you going to pick up a blind kid? Anyway, Django Fett, the angry vet. My vets, if you're having voices in your head, just like I do, because I think all vets got voices in their head saying to do bad things. I have them all the time. I just ignore them. It's when they start making sense. That's when you got to worry, when they start making more sense than the normal stuff. So be careful. Seek help if you need it, because it's not weakness to seek help. It's actually the strongest thing you can do. All right? My vets, be safe. God bless you. If you believe in God, I don't know what I'm saying. It's just habit. Anyway, take care. Have a good day. Django Fett, the Angry Vet, signing off.